name is Cassandra Peralta, formerly known as Cassandra Vega.
It's about to be loose. What is your name?
My name is Jace Williams, formerly known as Jace Williams, and forever Jace Williams.
What's your name?
My name is Victoria Jones.
How do you know Valerie Arioto?
I met Valerie on my official visit to UC Berkeley, where I went to school with her.
Was there anything that stands out to you about that visit?
No, she was super welcoming, super fun. We did go to her house for like a girls' night, I guess. We were in her pool house, which was a lot of fun. We played stones, we played pool, we were just getting to know each other.
How do you know Valerie Arioto?
So I met Valerie in 2009 after transferring from University of Washington. So I saw the 2009 season and met her in, I guess it was late 2009. So fall, when we got to school in the fall.
When you met her, were there any characteristics that stood out to you?
Well, being a playing against Val, I already knew Val. Because the only, no offense to Cal at the time, but the only person we would even like scout was Val. So I knew who Val was just because of that. And she was the only player we really had to watch out for hitting wise. So I kind of knew her from the other side of things, you know, from an opponent. So, and I knew that she's one of those quiet, confident, very confident, but can wreck shop on you real quick. So we were always very careful with her. So that's how I knew her, was as a competitor first.
How do you know Valerie, and when did you meet her?
I know Valerie because I played at Cal with her for about 3 years, and I first met her on my official visit in 2009.
Pivoting a little bit, what is like your first impression of her?
Valerie is hilarious. She always makes me laugh, and I'll never forget my freshman year. She convinced me that some girl on our team, her name is Franny, she convinced me that her name was Frances. But she was like, shh, don't tell anybody that you know her real name. And so the whole entire first semester, I thought I was keeping this big old secret that her name was Frances, when it was really just Franny. So there we go. Thanks, Val.
For those who don't know her that well, can you speak to a funny story about her in college?
I guess I would just say, you know, every time we wanted to go out or did anything with each other, she was always trying to sing, trying to hit the high notes, thinking she could sing like Mariah Carey, on the buses, at our pregame parties.
Was it different playing against her to when you played with her?
You know, Val's very, you know, she's not really, I mean, she's loud and she's fun, but she's very serious on the field. Like, she has that switch. And so we'll be goofing around, you know, at the bus. Like, she's always like, always down to have a good time and have fun, hotel, whatever, when we're running around. But when it's game time, like, I guess that was the main thing, that I never saw that fun side of her, really. I just saw the serious side. So it was cool to kind of see, like, both sides of Val, I guess.
So pivoting a little bit, to people who don't know, what is your favorite memory of you in college with Val off the field?
Well, the cool thing about our team, which is different than a lot of college teams, is we were all really close. So a lot of teams have, like, you know, a group of five girls here, a group of three, like all these little cliques. Like, our team would roll to a party like 16 deep. Like, yeah. So we used to have a lot of fun. We had a softball house where a bunch of the girls lived up in Berkeley Hills. And we would always kind of meet up before we would go out. And it was always, some of my greatest memories were at that house with Val. She's always dancing. I don't think people know that about her. Like, she's always singing and dancing, and she thinks she's a really good singer.
Now, pivoting more to the field, you said you played with her for 3 years. What is something that people don't know?
Valerie is very goofy. So in practice, she's always laughing, making a joke. She always keeps the mood up regardless of what's going on. She's a great leader. And that's definitely, people need to know about her.
On a serious note, Valerie was injured in college. Can you speak to her performance at that time and how she dealt with that injury?
Yeah, so I was actually not in practice the day that she broke her leg. But the whole time, you know, she was upset that she couldn't play. It was her senior year, which makes sense. But on her recovery, she was always in the cages, like one knee on a bucket, hitting the balls, making sure that she was ready to play for the U.S. national team that summer.
Now, you mentioned something interesting. For those who don't know, what's a national team compared to an Olympic team?
The national team is like the Olympic team, but they just play in the World Cup and some other tournaments. Usually the girls that go out are collegiate players that are either graduated or are considered one of the best. The Olympic team obviously goes to the Olympics, so I think the criteria is a little stricter and they're looking for the best of the best.
Yourself has gone to the collegiate level and you know Valerie, so you know what it takes. What would you tell young athletes who want to aspire to maybe going to college and then playing for USA?
So Val is what I like to call a blue chip. So Val has that something special about her. And she's one of those players, like a lot of people have that special talent, but it's what you do with that talent. And I think Val has always been a workhorse. I mean, I'm telling you, she used to come early, like Cassie was saying, when she was injured, she would, every day didn't matter. She'd do one hand, whatever she could do, she would do. So I feel like you need to, if you want to be an elite player like that, especially in a sport like softball, that's a little bit more of like a skilled sport, I'd say, you need to spend a lot of time doing the little things. Hitting is very, very difficult. And if you want to be a good hitter, you need to put in a lot of work, a lot of tedious reps to be good. And I feel like Val really is very special in that department too. She's very dedicated.
Now moving it back to college. Maybe not so much on the field, but like, you know, college for up-and-coming rising stars, these girls. How was it about being a college athlete and also seeing Valerie as a college athlete and saying to young women what they need to do to get to that level that you got to?
You know, for these girls coming up, it's all about working hard and keeping your love for the game. When you go on a team and all of the upperclassmen just love the game so much, it really emulates in these younger players. And I think right now, more than ever, you know, these college athletes have a huge platform. And I think everyone's doing a really good job of really showing these younger girls what it takes to get there and showing them just the love for the game. A lot of people lose their love for it. And just now, I think it's great what everyone's doing.
Why, in your opinion, are women's sports or athletes not getting the attention as male counterparts?
I think that we just haven't been put on the same stage. And I think the country is moving towards looking at females the same way as males.
As far as compensation and women athletes in the sport, and I know you might be biased, but with Valerie there, do you have any feelings or any way females can get paid as much as males?
Well, I think that that's totally dependent on the market. Do I think that Val absolutely is as talented as any, you know, anyone in their respected sport who's making millions? Absolutely. She is the best in softball player in the world. Okay? So if you say like the best baseball player in the world or the best football player in the world or the best, you know, that's a male athlete, they're making millions of dollars. So I think it's just more like the market of, you know, what we do here, what we're watching, and, you know, money's being put towards, you know, what's being seen the most and shown the most. You know what I'm saying? So I think that Val, to be the best player in the world at what she does, is really quite special. And it's really a testament to, you know, what female sports have come a long way, though. It really has come a long way, especially marketing-wise, because I see a lot more female athletes as far as endorsements and sponsorships go. So, I mean, I've seen a little bit more of that as of late. So I don't know. I just think she definitely deserves to be hooked up a little more than she is.
Now, pivoting to more serious, in these times of like, you will not silence us with the Megan Rapinos, and you know, Valerie being an athlete, I mean, if Team USA basketball is to play and then Team Softball USA, what is your feeling as far as like seeing your girl there, but maybe not being compensated the same? What is your take on that, your position?
You know, coming from the perspective of a female athlete, I definitely don't think that female athletes get the recognition and the respect that they deserve. In terms of compensation, there's really no comparison. I mean, female athletes, we really have to make it huge. And even then, U.S. women's soccer, they're not getting paid what they should. All female athletes really aren't. You know, we really aren't getting the respect of this whole entire world. I mean, for example, a small example, the Women's College World Series finals are played at the same time as the NBA finals. You know, there needs to be some kind of separation so we kind of get that respect that we deserve. We've worked so hard as female athletes, and right now they're working even harder. It's grown so much, and I think we need to be respected. I think the world needs to notice, like, hey, these girls are badass.
So can you speak to the fact that softball is back in the Olympics in 2020? Was it a sure thing?
No, I don't think anyone thought that it was a sure thing that it would be back, but everyone was super excited. But now they are taken out again for 2024 as of right now. So we're hoping that we can change that.
And how long was Valerie on the national team awaiting to be on the Olympic team?
I think it's like 9 years. I think it's like her 10th year on the team. So, I mean, she is the best, and I knew she was going to make it.
For those who might not know, in the generation we live with or in, what would you say to young athletes who are maybe waiting and not knowing, but to that characteristic that Valerie has, what would you say?
I think when you're playing any sport, but specifically softball, practice is super important, and committing yourself to the game. I think everyone is out, you know, competing for scholarships, hoping to grow professional softball, keeping it in the Olympics. So I think your job as a female athlete is just to work hard and try to beat everyone out.
Now, you alluded to earlier about the national team and the Olympic team. For those who don't know, what is the difference? And can you speak to the struggle of maybe what Valerie had to do when other players left the national team because it was an Olympic year?
Anyone that knows Val is not shocked in any way that if she puts her mind to something, she was going to be on the national team. She said it from the start. She said it while she was in college. She, you know, when all that stuff came, a lot of players were going to play professional, all this kind of stuff. Like, Val was never really jumping on that. Like, she wanted to wear USA on her chest, and that's all she talked about. So for her, to see her be able to go and get to this and do the big show, like, I'm so stoked for her, because if anyone deserves to, that's putting more time, had, you know, the attitude that she had to kind of fight through all the adversity that kind of got, you know, is it in, is it out, is it in, is it out. Being on the team, not even knowing if it was going to be voted back, I mean, she deserves, I'm so, so excited for her. She really deserves this, the Olympics, so I'm stoked for her.
Are you headed to Japan to watch her?
So, I really, really, really want to go to Japan, and I've made plans, but with this whole sickness thing going on, I've had to kind of, you know, be strategic with where I do have a place to stay out there, but I'm going to be watching beach volleyball and softball. So the softball games at Japan, for example, when they're playing Japan, I'm going to make sure that I'm there for the USA-Japan matchups for sure.
What is a quality or a trait off the field and on the field that Valerie possesses that you haven't spoken about already that young athletes you feel need to have?
Dedication. And here's the thing about Val is she is the best player in the world, in my opinion, as far as hitting goes. And that doesn't stop her one day from working super, super, super hard and putting in the time, even though she's the best player in the world. She's not satisfied with that. You know, so it doesn't matter. You can always get better. If you're not getting better, you're getting worse. And especially in a sport like softball, you know, hitting's very up and down. You know, you can be an All-American and one of the best hitters and you fail 60%, 70% of the time. So that's a high failure rate. So it really takes like an attitude and kind of self-drive to be successful and put in the work on your own and do the little things that maybe aren't that fun, like hitting, you know, 500 forehand swings off with the small bat, you know? Like, she does those things, and that's why she is who she is, and that's why she's been at the top since probably forever. I didn't know her playing club as a kid, but, you know, as a freshman in college, we were the same year. She was already there.
So Valerie was on the national team, but there was no really a know-how that it was going to go to the Olympics. For you viewing her, what do you want to say, like, to young women about what that took? Like, what was that? Like, how did you feel about that?
You know, women's softball always keeps getting taken out of the Olympics and put back in. And I know, even, you know, coming from a personal perspective, I know it's really hard to keep that motivation. When you're playing, you know, some girls might think, there's nothing for me after college. There's no, you know, professional women's softball. You know, it's great, it's growing, but they just don't make a lot of money. And I know a lot of women are torn with, do I start my career, do I start my life, or do I continue playing the sport I love? And I think I would advise, you know, my younger self, just to keep going. You never know what's going to happen. Yes, softball is going to be taken out of the Olympics again, but it doesn't mean you can't represent your country and then you can't still play the sport that you love.
What is a quality trait that you would want to tell these young women that they need to have to make it that far?
You know, one trait that all these young women need to have is confidence. You need to have confidence in yourself to continue to play, make those decisions. If you mess up, who cares? Keep going. Have that confidence in yourself and your abilities to continue to play, because you can do a lot more than you think.
Now, pivoting a little bit, knowing Valerie from when you met her to now, it's been about a decade. Has she switched up? Has she changed as a person?
Valerie's always been super genuine. She's not switched up. She's still the crazy wild person that I met, geez, like 10 years ago. But no, definitely not switched up. She's the same person.
Has she switched up? You've known her for about a decade. Is she any different from college?
I haven't been able to hang out with her as much. I mean, just, I live down here. She's been on the national team, and that's quite a commitment that she's had with that team. Like, I don't even, she doesn't have a lot of time ever, you know? So I haven't spent too much time off the field since we graduated, but the last time I got to hang out with her outside of the field was at Cassie's wedding. And she seemed like the same person, the same exact way, same exact Val that I remember. Always cracking jokes, always funny. Like, so I would say that I don't see much of a difference.
Yeah, so I knew that I wanted Val to be in my wedding. So I actually considered the dates that she would be out of town. Because, you know, she's played for Japan, she's lived in Florida, she's kind of been all over the world. So I picked the date that I thought was safe for her to be there, and she was able to make it.
As a friend, Val always has your back. She's the one that you can go to. She's the one that's going to, you know, really tell you, hey, stick to your guns. You got this. Val's a great person. She's a great friend.
Now, you mentioned meeting her and your first impressions. Now, a couple years down the road, has she switched up?
No, Valerie's always been the same since the first day I met her until now. You know, we go on vacations every single year together, and Val's always been the same. She's always been that goofy person, but also, I have your back, let's do it type of person.
In your opinion, what is her best play on field?
Best play, that's a hard one, because there's so many good ones, but I think it was last year in the World Cup at Irvine, might have been 2 years ago, she hit 2 home runs in the same game.
Do you remember who it was against?
I think it was against Chinese Taipei, but I don't know.
In recent days, what is a favorite memory of Valerie's playing?
Val hits home runs like every single at bat. So I'll never forget when I brought my boyfriend to watch her the very first time. She hits 3 home runs in one game, and it's just a testament to how great she is of a hitter. I mean, there's no comparing.
And now on this whole journey, looking back all the way from Cal as you wear the hoodie to where she is now, is it surreal? Like in your mind, she wanted to wear USA.
Nope. I knew right away. That girl was all Team USA the entire time I knew her, and I am not in any way shocked. I'm just so happy for her that it got voted back in, so she got all that work she did. Like, even if it didn't get voted back in, I mean, she still loves wearing the 3 letters across her chest. And that I admire about Valerie is that it was always about USA and playing for Team USA, and it wasn't, you know, about anything else. So, I don't know. I'm not shocked in any way that this is what her mind was set to, and this is exactly what's happening. So I'm just happy that the other outside factors that she had no control over worked out for her.
And lastly, what do you want to say to Valerie as you wish her on her road to Tokyo 2020 Olympics?
Valerie, we are so proud of you and so excited for you to compete in the Olympics. Hope you ball out and go Bears.
Valerie, you're amazing. I have so much confidence in you. You're going to do great in the Olympics. I can't wait to watch every single game. You're a rock star. Go hit a million home runs.
What would you like to wish Valerie on the road to Tokyo 2020?
To soak in every single moment of it, because she's earned every single moment of that feeling and the whole process and all the awesome stuff that she's going to get to experience there. She's put 10 years in, and a lot of crazy stuff's gone down, and she deserves every single second of that experience, and I really hope she just soaks it all in and just really enjoys all the effort and the swings. And I mean, at the end of the day, this is it, right? This is the pinnacle of what she's been doing and working towards her entire career. So I really hope that she gets everything out of that experience that she's looking for.
Breakfast at Tiffany's and bottles of bubbles. Girls with tattoos who like getting in trouble. Lashes and diamonds, ATM machines. Buy myself all of my favorite things. Been through some bad shit, I should be a savage. Who would've thought it turned me to a savage? Rather be tied up with calls and not strings. Write my own checks like I write what I sing. Yeah, stop watching.